Hello and welcome to the Healthy Lifestyle Conversations brought to you by Correct. I'm Izel Maden, your host and functional medicine certified health coach, joined by my amazing co-host and dear brother Eli, a certified health and life coach. Get ready for an inspiring and motivational journey filled with practical tools to guide you towards a healthier, happier version of yourself. Each week, we'll delve into science-backed, up-to-date information on nutrition, movement, sleep, breathing, relationships, stress management, and positive mindset. Throughout our conversations, you'll discover how these lifestyle factors not only contribute to your well-being, but also pave the way for a more meaningful, peaceful, and joyful life experience. So, whether you are tuning in during your morning routine or winding down in the evening, we are thrilled to have you with us. Let's embark on this transformative journey together. Good evening.
Hello, hi.
How are you doing?
Good, back to life. Thank you very much. I've been away for the last few episodes, so I had the pleasure to listen it on the podcast channel. That was very enjoyable. Thank you for that. How have you been?
Thank you. Great. I feel good. It's been a nice two episodes. It's quite interesting experience to be alone, but flowing, going with the flow. This week we will also talk about related to nutrition. Sorry, by the way, the headline is not right here. It's written episode 11. I'll correct that.
Okay.
This week we will talk about a little bit my journey of my energy levels. I had chronic fatigue, let's say like 5-6 years ago. When I had also my first child, and this week I decided to talk about this topic because this week especially I had an intense week, I'll call it, because my wife was sick for 2-3 days. She was in bed most of the time, so while she was trying to get better, I needed to support her. Also, we have now two children, one baby like 2 months old. I found myself like one baby is on my shoulder trying to get the gas out, and then playing with the second child basketball inside the house, and you know, trying to have an order in the house, like putting stuff from here to there.
Sounds like a superhero.
not trying to be superhero, but trying to be good enough, you know. Anyway, I thought what to talk about this week, and I said, just a minute, I need to give a recognition to myself and say that in 5 years from where I came to which point, which is, I think, amazing, and it's not, I want to tell about it because I did it, but because that it's doable for everybody. I didn't do any magic. I don't have any superpowers. I just have my changing my lifestyle to a healthier one, especially my nutrition. And through the nutrition, I think I could elevate my energy levels dramatically. This is what I wanted to share with our audience today. Oh, your camera is off. Eli is off, I guess. Okay. Well, maybe with this opportunity, change the name of our episode today. I'm sorry for the inconvenience. Until I will be back, I'm just correcting the topic of today. If Eli won't make it, I will continue alone. Eli is here. I hope you will hear him too. I see him.
Hello. Okay. Am I back?
Yes.
Okay. Good. So I was saying, even though you say you don't have any superpowers, I do believe each one of us have some superpowers, and most of the time it comes from any we might be living in life. So I would say it's your superpower that you had some fatigue before.
Eli is having some connection issues. Okay, so until Eli will be back, I will just start and we'll continue from there and we'll update him, right? So as I said, I think he was saying also each one of us has superpowers and it comes most of the time with challenges. So I had the challenge that I didn't choose to. I had the fatigue for a period of time. Just a couple of words where I was 5-6 years ago, as I said, when we had our first child, baby. So I really remember myself like going to the factory when I was also still as in, working as an engineer. And so at like 11 a.m. Already I was like exhausted and didn't have any power to continue to the day, and I just wanted to the working time will end until 5 p.m. I was just trying to stay and be productive, but it was very hard for me. And then coming back home, trying to help and support at home, being with the baby and my wife, it was really, really challenging for me. So those days are really in the past. And today I have much more power. Although, of course, always we have a way to go, but I feel much, much, much more better and doesn't feel any fatigue, and at least any chronic fatigue or stable fatigue. And I have energy to do engineering work and coaching, and also being with my family, two kids, raising them and being with them, enjoying them, and also with my friends at the weekends, etc. So this is where I stand now. So let's start how this change happened. So I will a little bit explain it chronic order, it doesn't have to be in the same order for someone else. And also I have to say that each one of us can have other root causes to the fatigue and energy depletion. For someone it can be a high stress working life, for another one can be childhood trauma, and another one can be like having some parasites in the body which are draining the energy from you, and for other person can be heavy metal toxicity. There are a lot of reasons, so I will just explain mine and also give you a like framework what you can do from nutrition perspective. So as always, by the way, you can write in the comments questions and your comments and questions so that we can also try to help you to answer or see your comments. First of all, I remember that the first thing that I did with my nutrition was taking the junk food, or let's call it the processed foods, from my diet slowly, of course not in one day, but mostly the white sugar and the white flour like bread, etc., all the pastry stuff I start to take out slowly, Coca-Cola, all the those kind of energy drinks and alcohol. And then I continue to be dairy free and gluten free in my diet in the couple of years. And then after taking those foods that mostly harm our health, I started to also take the toxic foods from my diet, which has like some sort of like added chemicals in them, and also the toxic cookware. This is also important. Not just the food that we are eating can damage us, also the cookware that we are using. For an example, they can be plastic bottles that we drink water, can be with BPA. Now they are banned mostly in most of the products. There was also Teflon widely used in cookware, so now less, but still you need to take care that you don't use Teflon, which can be cancerogen. And also I understood that we shouldn't use aluminium foils, let's say, and other things that contain aluminium, because there's a direct correlation between aluminium levels in your body and the Alzheimer's. So it's better idea to take the toxic ingredients from your cookware. And then I continue to also to take out the toxic things in from my house, which are the cleaning and self-care products like laundry detergents. washing liquids and deodorants, etc. I try to use all of them natural products instead. I talked about what I took out from my diet and other stuff in my house, but then I started to replace them with the whole food, mostly vegetables. For a period of time, I was also vegetarian, not because of my health reasons, but mostly ethical reasons. I ate more vegetables. And then I tried to find healthier alternatives to the, let's say, junk food that I was eating, if this is like protein bars, etc., these kind of things. And also use natural sweeteners like honey, maple syrup, etc. So this is the replacement part. After replacing the toxic foods or junk food and processed food with the healthier ones, I also started to add some gut healing foods and supplements together to my diet. Some examples for gut healing supplements are L-glutamine, and the foods you can add curcumin and probiotics, fish oils, creatine, aloe vera. Slippery elm is used most of the time, and also marshmallow root, licorice root, and also ginger is really helping and soothing the gut in order to fix the leaky gut issues, inflammation, and then also helping digestion at the same time. In my journey, after doing these kind of things, I already started to feel better. But still, I was having the chronic fatigue, and then I just tried to understand what can I do more for my health. And through functional medicine, I started to see what the root causes might be, and one of them was having some harmful organisms in my body that shouldn't be there. Let's say parasites, fungus. We have in our body those kind of things, but if the balance is, if we are out of balance and they are like outnumbering the good bacteria, let's say, in our gut, then you start to have some problems like the energy leakage. So I started to get herbal supplements to eliminate the parasites and fungus and also maybe mold you can have. So some examples are lies here. Hello, welcome back. So I just finished my sentence and I will update you where I am standing. You can use black walnut, wormwood, berberine, garlic, and oregano oil, which I still use oregano oil, which is really good for antibacterial and antifungus properties. Eli, welcome back. And I was just explaining how my journey plus nutritional changes.
I was actually able to hear everything, so I don't know why you weren't able to see me. One question there. Sorry if I missed it and if you did mention it. What did you replace the Teflon and the other kingware with?
Good question. So it's interesting. First of all, one of the things that widely used is aluminum oxide layer, which is also non-stick properties it has as Teflon, not as good as Teflon, but it can be a placement. But the thing is, you can ask, you talked about aluminum foil that we shouldn't use, and now you're saying aluminum oxide. So aluminum oxide is different chemical properties it has, and also aluminum is shouldn't supposed to leak through the cookware to your food when it's in oxide form. This is what I at least understood, and I'm also using it. There are good companies like Green Pen I know of, but there are a lot of companies, I guess. And also, you were using something, right? Maybe you can explain.
Yeah, some ceramic things. So the aluminum oxide is mainly called ceramic coated or ceramic pans, I think, isn't it? So it's the same thing. And then through your recommendation, they also got some glass cookware, so pans and so on. So they work nicely.
Also cast iron with some oil.
Yes.
Yeah, there is also.
Yeah. That also, yes. You need to treat them with oil. The best one is sunflower oil, but you do it only once. And then again, it's not released and it's very little amount and you do it just once. And then you can use it with any oil, obviously, as you recommend, olive oil, butter, ghee, coconut oil, avocado oil, whatever oil you want to cook with is fine. But initially, the one thing that works for it to be less sticky is sunflower oil, and that's done just once. Yes, it works really nice. The only thing is then you can't use detergents with it, so it's mechanical cleaning, but it works nice, especially for breakfast stuff.
Thank you for asking, actually. Practical things to talk about. I talked about until now what I took out from my diet, junk food and toxic things, and then I replaced them with the healthier ones and alternatives, and then I added some gut healing foods and supplements. And as I said, I was feeling better, but not really as let's say huge difference in my energy levels. And then I started to eliminate the fungus and parasites that I had in my body, that I had some indications that I have them, of course. In this point, I would recommend you to work with a practitioner. If it will be a functional medicine, I think it's better, because they are specialized in these areas of like root causes of your health issues. And then I think one of the stones in my energy journey, let's call it, was that I did some program of natural herbal cleansing program, detox slash detox program. It was like 4 and 6 months, and it was long. I had tincture of a lot of herbal supplements that I worked with one of the companies that I trusted.
And that's different than the elimination diet you were talking about earlier on one episode. So that's separate.
Yes, I will talk about elimination diet a little bit later. Yes, I didn't do the elimination diet. I think I also didn't know about that since then.
At the time.
Yeah, the times. And I did this program. It was focusing on, first of all, your colon health, gut health, and then liver. Cleansing the liver because it's the detoxification organ. It's making it stronger. And then it's also taking the harmful organisms that I already did, but I used also other stuff in addition. And at the end of the program, you use other supplements for heavy metal and chemicals detoxification in your body. And also in this period, of course, you need to eat clean and healthy and a lot of hydration, etc. If you can do also like movement, I will talk a little bit later than what I did for this. But yeah, from the supplement sense, this is what I did. This program, I think after this program, I just had really a jump in my energy levels. But still, I had way to go, and I just continued to search and, of course, live. And you know, I am enthusiast of healthy living since then, so I just continue to search what I can do for my health more. Of course, all of these around when I explained in 10 minutes, it's like a little bit overwhelming when you hear it, but I did it throughout the years, 5 6 years. And just think about that. I tried the intermittent fasting together with a specific diet, which is called autoimmune paleo diet. This I get from my functional medicine practitioner. I heard about it, I thought to do it, but I prefer to work with a functional medicine practitioner, and I did the intermittent fasting, autoimmune paleo diet, and together with that also some supplements to elevate my energy levels and to continue to detoxify my body. So I said I will come back to elimination diets. Autoimmune paleo diet is a little bit different from the regular paleo diet. The paleo diet, for the ones who don't know, is you are eating more, first of all, the natural foods, no processed food, etc. But you mostly eat healthy fats, protein like meat, etc., and less carbohydrates. And when you do the autoimmune paleo diet, you also take things out from your diet, the elimination diet that we talked about in the last episode. You take out the processed and refined foods, industrial seed oils, and you take out all the grains, not just the gluten containing, let's say also the rice and the legumes, all the legumes. You don't have dairy, you don't need eat even nuts and seeds, and also the nightshade family that I also talked about in the elimination diet, which it contains the potatoes, tomatoes, eggplants even. And also you don't eat eggs, coffee and chocolate. It was a pretty restrictive diet.
Sounds a lot. Is it also like 3 weeks of non-eating and then reintroducing? Is it similar to the elimination diet
It
also
is
with this one
similar, a
or?
bit longer. It was 3 months. I did
Okay.
it really
Yeah.
strictly, also from my German school background and discipline. I did it really, whatever I need to do, I did. It was
Yeah.
really challenging. I think it was more challenging to my wife because mostly she's cooking and it was very hard for her to find something to cook for me. But basically, you eat as much as organic if it's possible. You eat meat, fat, and the green vegetables mostly. A little bit maybe fruits that are low glycemic index fruits. So it was three months, and then I continued more three more months, but I added the things that I was almost sure that are not allergic to my body and not causing inflammation. Nuts, seeds, eggs, I get them back, and other stuff I continued not to eat. I did a little bit customization the next 3 months.
I can comment on two things at this stage. One is more technical, is with the intermittent fasting. Obviously now, instead of many diets being popular and being forgotten and so on, for a longish time now, intermittent fasting has been very popular amongst both practitioners and even doctors now and the public. Now, especially if you're doing it for fat loss and weight loss, which brings the burning of fat and the reduction in fat percentage. Now, one thing very important, especially to the first things you said about the toxins, whether it's coming from cookware or detergents, home cleaning products, or deodorants, perfume, or the food, they are mostly stored in fat cells in our body. And when you're going through this process of losing fat, when you kind of burn the fat, then the toxins are released back into the body. And you mentioned about detoxification supplements while you're doing that. Without that, if the toxins are going back into the bloodstream, they will go to the most fatty organs. So it could be liver, brain, and so on. So it's very important to take care of that. And again, this is something I didn't know when I started my journey again now, like 5 years ago. And I lost a lot of weight without knowing that. So without supplements. And then you might have more side effects like foggy brain and so on, brain fog, which can make it more difficult for you to continue the process. And also, if done right, it's much easier. And there's some preparation. With that, my second point is again, how it's nice now when we work with other people who have gone through stuff like this, whether it's business, whether it's health. Using their experience and knowledge, and then it's both easier, shorter processes. Also, it's great to have someone rooting for you, isn't it? If you would have. So sometimes it's difficult for the family, friends, and so on, when you're going through these stages. There is, I think, one person you can always rely on 24/7, every day, no matter what, would be your coaching. Because it doesn't depend on your relationships or the mood or anything. So it's good to have that support.
Yes, I wasn't aware of like coaching also in that period of time. But fortunately, at least I found functional medicine and some practitioners that could help me. But working with coaches, I think would be smooth process and not just giving the things that you need to do, and you need self-discipline to continue the process, especially when it's that much restrictive sometimes. But at the end of the process, I really started to feel much more better and energetic, and started to do the things that I really like to do. So today I'm really thankful that I had the courage and the power and persevere at that time, although my fatigue and discouragement of the fatigue. But working with a coach would really, really help to stay on the topic and not just to leave in the middle of the process. Intermittent fasting, by the way, I did a soft version of it, just like in maybe up to 18 hours, which was really, really helping me also lose fat, visceral fat, belly fat mostly, which is really an indication of most of the chronic health issues, by the way. I didn't do diets in my life, but for the first time in my life, through this diet with another purpose, I also lost my visceral fat in that period, and still I don't have most of the time. So intermittent fasting also helped me to do that. Also, maybe together with the detoxification, I didn't have the side effects that could damage my brain, my memory, and also the cognitive health in general. I will maybe end with my nutritional journey that I had after the diet. Of course, I came back to the healthy nutrition mostly, but not restrictive, not eating no rice and no nuts and eggs, etc., chocolate. So I'm occasionally, of course, having some wine, alcohol or chocolate or a little bit sugar here and there, but mostly I still have a healthy diet, and mostly I don't eat dairy and gluten. Maybe once a month or 2 weeks, just for the pleasure. And now, after like 6-7 years, now I don't feel really bloating, etc., all the side effects of gluten and dairy that I had for many years. So it took time, but it was worth it to go through this journey. Lastly, I have to say also, I said it before in last episodes, but through the practitioner, I also used some digestive enzymes and other stuff to help to digest the food, so that my intestines could absorb the nutrients that I had, the supplements that I had. This I didn't have beforehand. I think this was also very changing point in my also energy levels. So some examples of the digestive organ supplementations are the Swedish bitters, which is a liquid. It's bitter tasting, but it really helped me to digest better. And of course, digestive enzymes can help. And then for your low stomach acid, you can use betaine hydrochloric acid, HCl. And also, I'm still using, I also would recommend to use natural detox agents, but still, I have to say that you need to be careful with all detoxification agents. As Eli said, you can have detoxification and then all the toxic things can circulate in your body and come back to other organs. You need to take care of your taking toxins out.
Then you can use some binders, which are freely running in the blood, and then binders will remove them from the body. You need to debind it from the fat and then bind it again with another molecule so that it's thrown out.
Exactly. Using spirulina, chlorella, and then activated charcoals and these kind of things. And lastly, I would say that two more maybe things. Your energy level is dependent on how your mitochondria is working. I will not get into this because it can be another episode, but just to enhance my mitochondria health, which is the powerhouse of your cell, which is producing the energy you are having at the end of the day, you can use some other supplements for your mitochondria, like CoQ10, PQQ, NAD, and alpha lipoic acid. All these things are naturally you are having in your body, but when your system are damaged and not functional well, so these are depleted. When you supplement them, you can also elevate your energy levels. Last point maybe for nutrition, you can use also mushrooms, medicinal mushrooms they are called, and I also talked about it in the supplementation that episode that I talked about supplementation. Cordyceps, you can use also additional stuff that nature is giving you to use, are also used for thousands of years in some cultures. They are not new stuff, actually. This is the thing, my journey from taking things out, bringing them the healthier ones back, some supplementation, restrictive diets, some
yes, I mean, it's something really to congratulate, because it's such a vicious cycle when you're talking about depletion of energy and then making change, going through difficult times. And then some of these difficulties are self-made, isn't it? So it's difficult to go through those diets, just focusing on the end results. I guess one of the pills you must have had was the correct mindset. So do you want to say anything about that? Because without that, without enough focus and motivation, it's easy to give up. So any maybe last words for that? And then I think we also enjoyed this chat a lot.
Yes, this topic came out of the current situation in my life, that I have two children and my wife was sick this week, and I had the energy to support the house. My main motivation to start the journey was really being a good father, and also of course spouse, and to support my family, and not just support and being able to support, also enjoying the life, enjoying the family life that I really appreciate and love to have. And also, of course, then the circle of being with friends. So without energy, you don't do them. You cannot, even if you want. And this was my main motivation. It seems like outside motivation, but for me, it's inside motivation, because this is who I am. I'm a family person. When I am with my family and support my family and enjoy with my family, I really feel alive and vital. So from fatigue to vitality, this is my journey. This is really critical when you have the right mindset and focus for the future day to day. Of course, there are a lot of other things. I had for movement, I had yoga and qigong and hydration and sleep hygiene. I changed a lot of things for my sleep, and I was sleeping maximum maybe 6 hours and waking up at least twice at night. And now I can, if I have the right conditions, like not raising baby 1 month old, I can sleep through the night 8 hours, which is, you know, standard sort of. So I'm using some other technologies to check my sleep quality, and I see I'm not just sleeping long but also more quality deep sleep, REM sleep. And also I use a lot of things to support, also from psychotherapy to modern therapies like EMDR and EFT, emotional freedom technique, to release my emotional also stress, and also for my mental health, meditations, a lot of things, of course, to have the whole picture. But still I see the nutrition change was the main point, and healing the gut in the center of it.
It all sounds like you chose going for thriving instead of just surviving.
Yes, exactly.
Really nice. Thank you very much for sharing.
Thank you for listening. I don't know if there were some questions. If I missed, I'm sorry. So maybe you can repeat, or you can ask us and reach us in Instagram, Facebook, or YouTube channel. We have also, if you want to listen later on to our episodes, you can see us in Spotify, Castbox, and Amazon Music.
All popular channels, we are there.
And I hope if you enjoy our conversations, you can share with your loved ones.
Please do.
If there are no questions, we would love to see you next week again, as always. And it's good to see you live.
Perfect. You too. Have a good weekend. I will see you and the audience next week.
See you. Bye-bye. Have a full of energy week. Hi there, I hope you enjoyed this episode. You can subscribe to our YouTube channel to access all of our episodes and receive notifications for new releases. Additionally, you can listen to our episodes on Spotify, Amazon Music, Castbox, and Apple Podcasts. To stay updated with more content from Core Acts, we invite you to follow our Instagram and Facebook pages. feel free to save, like, and comment on your favorite episodes on your preferred platform. Lastly, we would deeply appreciate it if you could share and invite your loved ones to follow us on any platform convenient for them. This way, we can reach more people and contribute to elevating their health and life quality through healthy lifestyle changes. Thank you for your support.